we're going to do now is work on the actual handle, the actual shape of the handle here, which is not that object. That's for our midterm. We're going to be looking at uncrossed gladius. Bam. We're looking at this handle. 1, 2, 3, 4 little divots for the grip, which makes sense because it's a 5, 4 fingers, right? So I'm going to do this from the side view. I'm actually in the front view here. Go back to the create panel, and I'm going to go into the shapes. Okay, we've been working in three-dimensional objects here, which is the primitives. And last week, we looked at extended primitives as much as we looked at the standard primitives. What we're going to look at is the next one over, and that's shapes. And it's a circle and a square overlapping each other. And we're going to use a line. And what we're going to do with a line is that we're going to use, we're just going to put points down, and then we'll be able to shape it. And there's several different kinds of points to look at. So let's go ahead and start with one basic line. If I just grab this and just rotate this right here, that'll make a cylinder if I rotate it, which is not that exciting. But if I go in here and actually change it up a little bit, so let's do this. Make a simple polygonal wine glass so you guys can see it. Stick that up at the center. Now I'll go into my modify panel. What we're looking for is lathe. Right? Now the lathe, that looks just like a wine glass. It's perfect. Y'all agree? Best looking wine glass ever. So if I go to lathe and I change my axis, I can actually change the pivot point where it sits and where the actual lathe is spinning. Alright, so that looks a little bit more respectable of a wine cup, but not that great. Now, on top of this, what else I can do is I can come back into the line, into the actual stack, and go in here and actually add some things. So I'm going to refine this line, and refine just allows me to drop a vertex in there. So I'll right click to get that. So I'm going to grab that vertex. I'm going to slide this down here, slide that up, slide that up. So now I've actually got kind of an idea of where my glass is going to be full. Put that here, hit refine. And this is a good exercise to kind of figure out how this stuff works. We don't need a big base. I go back up here, close that, go back up here, and then I can go and look at it. A little bit more like a wine glass. Fantastic. That's amazing. We're the best ever. Agreed? Agreed. All right. Let's do a handle. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to keep it real simple, real polygonal. Drop here, and then I'm going to come down, come back up. Now, what I could do is try to redraw that shape over and over and over, and that's a real pain in the butt. Copy, paste. So what I'm going to use is the clone tool. So let's get this vertex kind of lined up a little cleaner. There we go. Boop. I'm in sub-object mode. I'm in my segments, which allows me to grab all my segments there. I can move them and everything I want to do. I'm going to hold shift. I'm going to clone that. I'm just going to do one real quick. And what we got to do is we got to weld these vertices together. All right, so let's get that vertex. I'm going to slide that right there. Grab those vertices. And now I want to get into a discussion about what it means to have what welding influences and the threshold. The threshold is basically the distance between one selected vertex and another selected vertex. And that's the distance between these two. If it's in a certain range, they'll snap. If I hit weld, they snap, so they're within this 0.1 threshold. So let's undo that real quick so I can kind of illustrate a little bit more. Let's pull that up here, pull that down here. So now, if I select those two vertices, I want to weld them. They're a single object. Hit weld. I'm outside that threshold. Whatever this distance is, it is less than this distance here. So if I go in here and slide this down, just going to move it back up, and slide it back up. So let's see. If I select those, hit weld. Still too far. I can just bring. So what? That's okay. The question is, there's no problem asking a question. But I'm going to go ahead and just bring it here. So what else I can do here is I have those. I'm going to quickly just click on the fuse. That's going to snap them into the exact same X, Y, Z coordinates. Not welded. I still have two vertices selected, but at least they're in occupied the same space. I can now hit click weld, and now it's a single object. Or single vertex. Went from two vertices to spline 1, vertex 6 selected. Now, do y'all see something different about this one? This one has no green boxes next to it. This one has two green boxes next to it. And so what I have here is I have a corner vert which means it's just two straight lines snapping into it. And then this right here is called a Bezier. This is the actual Bezier handle and allows me to change the shape of the actual curve. If I'm going to click on this, I'm going to right click on it. I'm just going to go ahead and make it a corner and just make it nice and solid. Now that I have this vertex selected, I can actually hit delete and delete just that vertex. That is not the same as deleting the segment or the spline element. Vertex will just delete the one vertex, which gives me a nice clean shape right here, so that's fine. So I'll go here, I'm going to select three or the spline, I'm going to hold shift, and there's my base, there's my handle right there. So get it set up to where it's pretty close to being the same size. Now I'm actually kind of extended past the side of it, so what I'll do is when I build everything up, I'll make it a single object, or I'll scale it down to where it fits. So again, I need to weld those vertices. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit fuse to snap them, hit weld, so now it goes to one vertex, and delete it just to get it out of the way. Then grab the whole shebang, and I'm just going to scale it down in the Y just a tad. Get it to fit. All right, cool. Now, I'm going to hit this little box right here. It's called Isolate Selection. It's also called Alt-Q. If I click on that, it's going to hide everything but this one object that I'm working on. What I want to do here is just go ahead and grab, I'm going to grab my vertices, and if I can I scale them, we'll get into that later. I'll deal with that later. I want to show you a couple more tools on that before I get to it. Let's go ahead and jump onto the actual lathe. I go here, I think it's a parametric. Let's see, taper test. Nope. Let's see, it's probably a spline. So patch spline editing tools. There's lathe. Sweet. Easy thing to handle. You guys can grip that, right? No problem. Deadly. Now, go to sub-object, hit axis. I'm going to move the actual axis point. I can un-isolate everything and make sure I get the right scale. Get a little bigger. And go into here. Now I'm in the top level. Now I want to kind of center this thing in here a little bit. now what I can do is start anticipating how I'm going to attach this. First things first, this is a 16 segmented object. We've been working hard on making that happen. So I click on this one, I'll make sure that it's 16 as well. And it is, which means it's going to match up great. So let's go here and let's get this mesh prepared. A lot of the work's been done for us if we've gotten this far with the Edit Poly Tools. If I go to the polygon mode, select these polygons here, I hit delete, and now what I can do is attach. I can attach this right here. So what I'm going to do first, this is a key thing I want you guys to remember. I'm about to make a big step. What I'm about to do is commit my handle, which has all these wonderful things that I can access. I can actually go in here and grab these things. I'm going to turn test tube on. It'll show the top result. I'm going to grab, hold control, and grab all these pieces right here. And I can access those things a lot faster than I would if I actually were to make this an editable poly. So I don't want to lose that work. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit save as, and I always use save as. Go to Gladius 01, which is where I'm working. I'm going to hit plus. So now I have Gladius 02, and I've basically got a hard history, right? So what I can do now is I go here, and I'm going to go ahead and hit attach, and attach our new object to the old. Now I'm going to go and test out all of the borders. So here's this border here. That's that open hole, and there's one here. So what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to scale. I'm going to move this down a little bit. I'm probably going to go ahead and just scale it up a little bit to make it fit a little tighter. Select those two borders. Boop, boop. Hit connect or bridge. Boop, boop. Awesome. All right, same thing. Let's go ahead and grab that border. I'm going to move this up. And I'm going to scale it out a little bit. Since this, the guard is oval and the actual handle is round, so I want to go ahead and just scale it just to the Y to kind of get it a round shape so it matches a little better. I can probably go ahead and make it a little bit bigger, not small, bigger than the one I'm going to bridge it to. So click on border, hit bridge. And there we go. There's our complex handle on a nice simple shape. Now the next thing I want to talk about, other than splines, and we'll be using splines for other things as well, so I want you guys to keep that fresh in your mind and play around with this stuff. It's a very powerful tool that a lot of the current developers find dumb, and I don't ever understood it. When I show them these tools, they're like, oh, that's really awesome. What we want to work on now, we're going to attach this complex shape because we've got four sides going into 16, and that's messy. So what I'm going to do here is grab that vertex. I'm going to hit delete. Now I want to show you something. I'm going to grab this border. This is why the border tools are amazing. I'm going to grab border. It's not showing everything, but that's weird. My display isn't actually acting up. Anyway, I'm going to scale, and I'm in uniform scale. Hold shift, which is our clone tool, right? Shift clones. If I hold this and scale, now I'm actually cloning geometry. This is like extrude or bevels that we'll get into a little later. This is one of the coolest things I love about this tool, about this software. Not a lot of tools actually have this cloning of the sub-object stuff. And so it's really nice. I'm going to hold shift and do one more. I don't know how big my blade is, but I'm going to go ahead and get it. We can go right here and take a look at it. So that's good. So I'm going to scale this down to make it fit the actual size of the blade. Now, the trick here is going from, I'll move this up a little bit so you can see it. We're going from 16 edges to 4, but since we're using quads and we're sticking with the visibles of 4, that's simple math, 4 to 16, that's just half of it. So all I got to do is basically lose about half the geometry on my connecting edge, which is this one. So what I'm going to do here, I want to be selected. I was showing you collapse in the last video, and this is what we can do here. So I'm going to click on this and I'll show you collapse. Well, let's mirror that, collapse. So let's do this from the side view so we can move a little faster. So I'm going to undo both of those. You can see right there, I can go here, and go here, and go here, and go here. I'm selecting what I already know what I want to do, so just I have an idea of what I'm going to go with. If I hit collapse here, all right, so if I click on the border, I have 8 edges. We're halfway there. So what I want to do now, instead of collapse, because I'm going to lose, if I hit collapse here, what collapse is going to do is going to bring the middle, it's going to bring this vertex and this vertex into the middle space of where they sit. So if I click here and hit collapse, I may lose my alignment. And I don't want to do that. So what I want to do is I want to bring this vertex itself to this location. Keeps the integrity of this vertex just fine and allows me to actually collapse these two together. And what I'm going to do for that is called target weld, which what it allows me to do is drag the vertex I want to weld to the actual vertex I'm welding it onto. So the one I want to get rid of to the one I want to get it to where I want to move it to. So click and drag. Click and drag. All right. Now, it's not necessarily pretty, but it's getting there. So I hit 3 to get to the border. Now let's bring this. Let's go ahead and attach our blade. I'm going to delete this polygon because we got to delete faces to make holes so that we can weld everything. Grab this down here, slide it right back down. I hit 3 to go to both these borders. I can bridge that. Now I have extra stuff for my sword. So let's go ahead and I'm going to grab this real quick. Go to the polygons. Just slide it up. And there is our single solid object, airtight mesh, the Gladius. And so that's what we're going to be, I want you guys to work on. So let's go ahead and stop, and I'll post.